1994, and on my first day, I remember going to work saying, I wonder what we're going to do today, and I got to work at 20 to 9, and Dr. Price walked into my office and said, haul ass, we're going to Chicago, and we had a 10 o'clock flight, and that was my first day, and it's been a great ride for me ever since, because he's done some amazing things, as you know, in this hobby. He recreated Parkhurst. He was a collector when he was a boy. He loved Parkhurst. When he had the opportunity, he grabbed it and started that brand all over again. And I don't know if there's a more beloved brand in hockey than that. And then he moved into reviving the Be a Player brand. I think you all remember that. Did well with that and then created In the Game and Sport Kings. He's a creative person. He lives on being creative. He's done some amazing things. And he loves the collector because he's a collector himself. Now, many times I've come to him and I would say something like, you know, if we take this jersey and we don't worry about cutting multicolor pieces for people, we're going to save money because we don't have to buy as many jerseys. And he says the line that he said to me so many times, Ken, if you're a collector, would you want that piece or would you like a multicolor piece? It's always about the collector. I'll say, you know, we don't have to put four memorabilia cards in this product. Ken, if you were a collector, would you like four memorabilia cards in this product? And that's what Dr. Price is all about. He's about the collector. He's about doing things like this tonight for all of you. And it's my very great pleasure to introduce to you Dr. Brian Price.
Thanks, Ken. The easiest way to do a lot of things right is to do a really lot of things, and you're bound to get a couple of them right every now and then, so I was fortunate to do that. I have sort of a very, very important announcement to make tonight.
I think you should get some quiet for that one.
That really stems from the fact that in 2003, we lost our NHLPA license. And thanks again. It's probably Calvin again. We lost our NHL license and our NHLPA license in 2003-2004. It's not a secret to anyone when the lockout took place. And I guess a lot of people, including the NHL and the NHLPA, felt that it was time for us to close up shop. And whether I was too stubborn or too stupid, I'm not sure which to do it. We decided not to do that. And we had five successful years as being the alternative, card company for collectors who were dissatisfied with Upper Deck, and that wasn't a bad position to be in. The 3 years after the exclusive was over and Panini was in the marketplace was extremely difficult for us because now collectors had another alternative, and now they had three, and with our limitations of rookie content and our limitations of being able to use logos, we found it was increasingly difficult to stay in business, but again, too stupid, too stubborn, not really sure which. Over the last few months, I've been contemplating my role in the hobby, and probably it's time to hang them up, and you don't want to overstay your welcome. But again, the old adage that I've said twice already tonight, too stupid or too stubborn, I'm not going to do it. But I feel that with the new exclusive that's taken place, another number of years, I'm not sure anyone really knows how many numbers it is, but I'm going to suggest 2 or 3 years that Upper Deck will have as an exclusive again. I think that I'm obligated to reinvent In the Game. And the way I'm going to do that is I am going to amalgamate, not in the legal sense of the word, but in the sense of the word of taking on joint venture, partner, whatever you want to call it, in trying to move the company forward. A group of people who I've admired from afar for a long time in terms of their ingenuity, in terms of their distribution, and I'm talking about Leaf trading cards. So as of today, Lord Stanley's Mug will be our last product as In the Game as you know it. We are going to have an amalgamation with Leaf trading cards where Leaf will handle distribution, parts of the manufacturing, a lot of the things were decided this weekend, so they're not etched in stone. But that will be the first product that we'll be working with Leaf, will be the 2014 draft prospects. My new associate feels exactly the same way as I do about the situation with respect to licensing. And he's had to be creative in the products that he's made. The only difference between the two of us, he's 20 years younger than I am, and he's has a lot more fight in him as little David's trying to conquer all the big Goliaths. So we are going to go together to be stronger, to be better equipped to battle the battles that we have on hand, and we're not gonna go out of business, licensed or unlicensed, and the time will come when I believe that the collector will finally have a say, and when the collector does have a say, I think the licensing landscape may change. So right now, I'd like to bring up my new partner, associate, amalgamated, co-manufacturer of In the Game Trading Cards, Brian Gray from Leaf Trading Cards. Yay!
I get emotional about this stuff, so bear with me if I cry like a sissy. First off, In the Game, as you know, it is not dead. Make no mistake, In the Game, as you know, it is here. Brian Price has done amazing things. I'm a little bit cocky sometimes. Give him a big hand. I think he deserves it. You know, I'll tell you, I'm a little cocky sometimes, and hopefully you'll get to know me, and I'll be a good cocky, not a bad cocky. I used to think I was the most creative guy in the business until I met Brian. And I realized this guy has fought the good fight. And I think with what he's done, you don't throw away the foundation of what he's built. I think you look at that and you say, let's take it the next step. Let's do some things we haven't been able to do. Let's continue to build on quality game used memorabilia, stuff that's real, not stuff that we don't know the origin of. Real game used, quality autographs. And those are some of the things we do at Leaf also. We're the monster at getting incredible autographs you never think you could get. We brought Ichiro back from the dead in baseball. He hadn't signed for many years. We brought him back. In entertainment, we had Britney Spears, Harrison Ford, Al Pacino, Jennifer Lopez. So obviously, we're capable of delivering names that people never thought were possible. I think together, we're in a position to put up an even bigger fight. And I think ultimately, the collector deserves what we're going to put up. Because one choice is not enough choices at the end of the day. So I think the most important thing is Brian Price is fighting with me. And as he always has been, we're listening to what you have to say. Because ultimately, that's the only reason we're here. We can love this business to death, but without you guys, it doesn't mean anything. So rather than ramble on, there's still lots of drinks, so I'm not gonna stay too long, but the biggest thing is we're here tonight, interact with us, because at least that's always been my mission statement, is to listen to the collector, actually hear what he says, and then try to deliver it. Not lip service. Not send me an email and some flunky sends you an email back. That's not how we operate at Leaf. I know that's not how Brian Price operates. And as we move forward, I promise you, you're gonna have an experience that is at least as strong as the positive experience you've had so far. So again, I thank you guys for graciously welcoming me to the party. I love this hobby as much as anyone, and I really appreciate you guys, because just watching you from afar this weekend, your support, watching people open the product, and the excitement they get from finding incredible game news they can never find anywhere else, that's something I haven't seen in the hobby in a lot of other segments. The hockey collector is very different than the baseball, football, basketball collectors we see in the States. You guys are real collectors, and there's something to be said for that. I'm really excited to be part of this interaction with you guys. So thank you guys for coming out tonight. It's awesome that you're here. We're gonna be rotating around throughout the night. We'd love to interact with you. I think that's critical. So Ken, what do we got cooking now?
A hand for Brian Gray, first of all. Thank you very much. Thank you, Brian Gray. Brian was...
One more thing. A lot of you expected Pete Rose to be here tonight. Pete had a doctor's visit that didn't go as well as we hoped, and he was not able to fly. He sent me a video that if I could project it up here, it was quite cute. But he basically said, guys, I am so sorry. He had a little heart issue. Nothing, he's gonna make it, it's not bad, but he just can't travel. But he basically said, you know, he's sorry he couldn't make it, he hadn't been up here in many years, and he pledged that he will be back, hopefully for the next show, but we will have Pete Rose here. He was so gracious, even though he's a little under the weather, we overnighted him cards, he signed quickly, I think you got them when you came in. So Pete Rose, he was sick that he couldn't be here, because Pete is one of the ultimate guys when it comes to interacting with the fans. I've had him in appearances where he talked for an hour just about baseball. I mean, he's one of the best guys ever. So we'll bring him back soon. We're sorry he couldn't be here, but hopefully we'll find some way to surprise you, as In the Game always has.
Frank Gray, everybody. Thank you, Frank. So Brian and I were talking earlier, talking about the Leafs. He was talking about the Leafs' goaltending problems. And Brian said to me, I don't know who their goaltending coach is, but you got to get somebody in here to show them how to control the rebounds. Because he watched some of the games and he goes, the goalies can't control the rebounds. So Brian, just like the other Brian, because they get stuff done, has brought somebody in to help the Leafs. So if we could have him come out, in order to help the Leaf goalies learn how to control the rebounds, very special guest, visitor to Toronto. We're going to let Dave Notice know about this as soon as possible. Dave Notice may be here. The master of rebounds. The greatest controller of rebounds in the history of basketball, Dennis Rodman! I'm sure Dave Notice is on his way.
So Dennis is here tonight to sign autographs for...